y'all ready for this?
Howdy folks, Roage here. This is the new recon video called Pope Papa Loser. Something happened today, pretty interesting. I'd like to go over it with you. The Pope has made a pretty important statement today. Comes as no surprise to me, and I will go into that right now. Today, this video, I'm going to do from the basement. There we go. lots of things going on down there, and this place is going to be busy. All right, so let's get to what the Pope said today. And this has come out everywhere. So I decided to just choose one of the articles there from a source that, you know, most people, appreciate. I don't know how much they respect him, but you know, look, this is all over the place. I mean, I believe it originally came from Reuters. This particular journalist picked it up and did a story, and here it is. It's from the Washington Post. The links are in the description, it's an article done today, December 21st, 2018, by Julie Zausmer. Hopefully I pronounced that correctly. It was titled Acts of Faith. It was under the category Acts of Faith. And, you know, I'm going to read this stuff to you, and we'll, you know, let you know how important this is. It says, the Pope says, hand yourself over to human justice. Pope Francis tells priests guilty of abuse that the church won't shield them. Okay. Now, turn yourself over to human justice. Okay. Now, these are administrative and procedural courts, which are about as abominable as what these people are actually doing. Okay. But Pope says the church won't shield them. More accurately, the church can't shield them. Okay. Not without losing all lawful authority. And one can question whether they have the authority anyway. I certainly do, because I've made proof, unoffered proof. Okay, so continuing into the article. Now, I edited the display for this. Now, I would suggest that you go to the link and read it for yourself. This is an excerpt. There's a paywall there. You know, if you like the article, hey, you know, I don't see a problem with actually supporting him. Seems like a reasonable article, one of the more useful things that have come out of the Washington Post or any of the media for that matter, because this is indeed important. Okay, so next, there's a video there. You can watch that if you'd like. That's actually the Pope making the statement. It says in the caption here, it says, Pope tells priests of abuse to turn guilty of abuse to turn themselves in. This is during his annual Christmas address at the Vatican on December 21st. Pope Francis urged priests guilty of sexually abusing minors to turn themselves in. And again, that says from Reuters. Then it says Pope Francis, and this is the body of the article here, Pope Francis used one of his major annual Christmas speeches to offer some of his strongest words yet on the sexual abuse crisis in the Catholic Church, telling guilty priests that the church won't protect them and they should turn themselves in. And then he says, and this is quoting him, he says, to those who abuse minors, I would say this, convert and hand yourself over to human justice and prepare for divine justice, Francis said in a speech at the Vatican on Friday, which is kind of an interesting thing if you know how he ties human justice with divine justice. I'll go in, and like I said, this is not a surprise to me because I sent a letter, and I believe he got that letter. I'll go into that. Okay, so further in this article, he says, he promised major steps to prevent abuse that will emerge from a February summit of bishops, a renewed commitment for a pope who has been criticized as weak in his response to abuse. Weak. Weak. Okay. Weak. All right. Speaking to the Roman Curia, the central governing leadership of the Vatican, Francis described at length the sinfulness of priests who prey on children, often behind their boundless amiability, impeccable activity, and angelic faces. They shamelessly conceal a vicious wolf ready to devour innocent souls. What kind of image is he portraying here? Often behind their boundless, he's just saying that they shamelessly conceal a vicious wolf. This guy, I got nothing, folks. I mean, I got nothing here. Okay, all right. He said in remarks that drew often on the example of the sinful biblical King David. Let it be clear that before these abominations, the church will spare no effort to do all that is necessary to bring to justice whosoever has committed such crimes. The church will never seek to hush up or not take seriously in any case, which is a profound change from perhaps the beginning. And his reference to King David is kind of interesting. Okay, now, again, I mean, King David, you know, you say what you want, but there were some unusual activities around him, and look, I mean, he's pointing, the Pope is pointing to something, okay? So let's see here. That was 5 and 6. Now, on the 13th of September, 2018, I tweeted a message, put it out on Facebook, and actually seriously attempted to inject this into the lawful command chain of the church. I believe they got the message. The reason I say that is because of the terms that the Pope is using in his message and the absolute certainty of some of the things that he's actually saying. And you'll see why when I read this letter. This went out the 13th of September, okay? I said, to the man, okay, I'm addressing the man, not the person in office, okay? So I'm penetrating his office, and I'm going right to him as the man, okay? To the man known by his parents as George Mario Bergoglio. Okay, then I reference his title, and that's pretty important. Okay, Bishop of Rome, Vicar of Jesus Christ, Successor of the Prince of the Apostles, Supreme Pontiff of the Universal Church, Primate of Italy, I always like that one, Archbishop and Metropolitan of the Roman Province, Sovereign of the Vatican City-State, and Servant of the Servants of God. Sounds impressive. Looks like vanity to me. Don't know. I mean, you know, what do I know? Just the appearance there. Okay. Looks like vanity. All right. Dear George, I am thankful to our supreme holy benefactor and your dutiful example. I see you are now beset by demonic vexation, and I am commanded by our supreme holy benefactor to humbly provide you with a divine remedy. I know the eyes of the world are on you right this very moment. So I will provide you the divine remedy post haste. As you, being the servant of the servants of God, and I, being a humble servant of God, I, under that lawful authority and precedent, as ordained by our supreme holy benefactor, hereby command you, my servant, to reconcile the following passages in the Holy Bible and answer the questions that follow, as an authorized ordained official of the Holy Roman Church, by sovereign proclamation before noon, Greenwich Mean Time, the 13th of October, 2018, Anno Domini. Now, what did I just do? He espouses the title of servant of the servants of God. I'm one of those. I'm his boss. And by his word, he is bound. That's the law. He doesn't have a choice here. Period. End of story. He complies, or they're done. The whole thing is done. So I said, he's to make a proclamation by the 13th of October, 2018. Didn't. Disobeyed. Lied. Failed as a public servant. Failed everyone on this planet, even himself. Most especially, the boss. I don't do this on my own authority. I don't have to. He should know full well what he's dealing with. So I say, reconcile this passage with another passage that follows. But this is the first passage. Okay? And it's from Ezekiel 16, 48 through 50 of the Holy Bible, Authorized King James Version. Now, some of the text in the Authorized King James Version is a little cumbersome, but hopefully you can get the gist of what it actually says here. It says in 47, "Yet hast thou not walked after their ways, nor done after their abominations, but as if that were a very little thing, thou wast corrupted more than they in all thy ways. As I live, saith the Lord God, Sodom, thy sister, hath not done, she nor her daughters, as thou hast done, thou and thy daughters." All right, so what he said. All right, okay. So he's talking to Israel, and he basically said, well, you know, Sodom and Gomorrah didn't do as you did. They did something else. They were pretty much at variance with the program. Okay? So then he said, "Behold, this was the iniquity of thy sister Sodom, pride, fullness of bread, and abundance of idleness was in her and in her daughters. Neither did she strengthen the hand of the poor and the needy. And they were haughty and committed abominations before me. Therefore, I took them away as I saw good." All right. Now, everybody knows the story of Sodom and Gomorrah and what happened. Okay. They were wiped out. Okay. Vanquished. Completely rubbed out. Why? We're all believing that it was because of their, let's say, sexual creativity. But that's not why they were wiped out. It says right in here why they were wiped out. And it wasn't what we all, you know, supposedly think. What did it say? They had pride, fullness of bread, abundance of idleness. Neither did she strengthen the hand of the poor and the needy. That's what did it. And I say that the Roman Catholic Church is got plenty of bread, pretty idle, some pride there, but they are not strengthening the hand of the poor and the needy. They're abandoning the poor and the needy. Here is the Roman Catholic Church that has great potential for helping the poor. Are they teaching the poor the law? No. In fact, all we have is administrative courts out there and procedural courts, which are fictions of law. And those in the Vatican know how to teach the people how to convene a court of law and eliminate criminality in this society of the world. Of all the organizations in the world, the Roman Catholic Church knows the law. And they are not teaching people the law. They are not. It's me, you know, somebody nobody listens to out here. Where are they? Backpedaling, apparently. Outrageous, folks. Abominable. Why it took so long for them. Next page. Now you reconcile that reference to Sodom and Gomorrah, why they were wiped out, with this one. And this one comes from Roman 13, again, from it's from the Authorized King James Version. And remember that I identified him as the man, not the office. And as the man, Bergoglio, or Goglio, Magog, funny that. I can penetrate his office. Okay? Romans 13. Let every soul be subject unto higher powers. Pretty clear there. Everyone. Him too. For there is no power but of God. The powers that be are ordained of God. Okay? Whosoever therefore resisteth the power, resisteth the ordinance of God, and they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. Now, is this a rebuke of the little guys out there not doing what the church says? No. This is the leadership of the church not doing what they're supposed to be doing, right? They're the ones resisting, not the little folks, right? For rulers are not a terror to good works, but to the evil. Got it? Wilt thou not be afraid of the power? Do that which is good, and thou shalt have praise of the same. For he is a minister of God to thee for good. But if thou do that which is evil, be afraid. For he beareth not the sword in vain, for he is a minister of God, a revenger to execute wrath upon him that doeth evil. Folks, if those that claim authority aren't on the right track, we have a responsibility to hold those people accountable for their crimes. That's what we're commanded to do. But we shouldn't even be doing that. Why? Because they should be doing that themselves. Are they? Nice words, though, from Bergoglio. Okay? All right, so, in a proclamation, he was to reconcile these two passages. Okay? I says, you are commanded to answer the following questions and provide proof for your answers. 1. Why do those under your authority and for whom you are both responsible and accountable for in the Holy Roman Church and under God allow their unclean body parts to find their way into the innocent bodies of God's young children? Why do those in the church authority protect those that violate God's sanctified children under his watchful eye? Those are the two questions that he was to answer. Did he? No. So now here I'm reminding him of how law and power works and how he gets his authority. He don't have any. This was an effort to actually establish that. He failed, folks. He failed. You know where he's going. Okay? This is me reminding him of how things work. I know the level of fear in men as they revere our supreme holy benefactor. I am honored to assist you in further cultivating within you an abundant increase in that prudent respect. Now, some of the things that this Pope has said about him having doubts that God exists tells me that there's no fear in him. He does not realize what he's dealing with. He's excommunicated. Because if he was communicated, he would have absolutely no doubt whatsoever. None. He would have a degree of certainty that is, it should be a model for everybody on this planet. But he betrayed that. There are people who are lost, who are looking for guidance. They want to know that this being, this supreme holy benefactor exists. And he's up there saying, well, shoot, I have my doubts. No one in a position of authority has permission, my permission, to do that. Shouldn't have your permission either. So then I go on, I say, I also, as most that look to your loving leadership, that it is not in you to fail to do your duty as commanded. I look forward in highest praise of our supreme holy benefactor and great anticipation of the wonderful revelation you are about to release to the world and the enormous good works that are about to bring forth in both unparalleled respect and humility when you succeed in executing this divine remedy. May you be blessed in all things, and I stand ready to qualify your proof. Love and respect, Roage. The meek and humble protector of his holy grail. He failed. Plain and simple. Didn't get it done. There was a time limit. He failed. If he didn't get the notice, that's proof that he's not sovereign. Why? This message didn't come from me. If he is the man he thinks he is, He would have got the message, and he would have done what it was that he needed to do. He failed. That's not the most unsettling thing. He knew he wasn't qualified to be Pope. Not only that, but everybody who offered him as a candidate, they knew also. He should have recused himself, called himself ineligible, because that would have been the truth. But instead, he perpetrated a lie. The leadership did also. And now they suffer. Now they're being shaken. They have lost divine right. I don't know if it's recoverable, folks. What you're seeing is the train wreck afterwards. You know, promise is if you're ignorant of the law, you get delivered into the hands of the evil men. All right? This is them. Right? Ignoring the law. So now they're going to be delivered into the hands of the evil men. Right? What was that? What was the main statement here? Hand yourself over to human justice. Human is akin to a monster in law. They're to hand themselves over to the monsters. Instead of being a model to teach people the law, to show people how to convene a lawful court, to show people how to rid themselves of criminals who are abusing them with impunity. The weakest of us, the old. We have homeless starving to death. There is no reason whatsoever for that. Absolutely no reason. And this, huh? A leader? A spiritual leader? Chief betrayer? He had one job, folks. One job. I can't rebuke him any stronger. I gave him all the lawful authority and power that he needed to actually reconcile this, and he failed. No excuse. Not only did he fail, but everyone who calls themselves good and conscientious within that entire organization, they failed also. We need a reconciliation. We, as people, need to learn the law so that we can get rid of these criminals. And I don't mean going around and hanging these criminals, but people need to know how things work here. And the Pope has a responsibility to show people that. I mean, these people have been sitting on information that's been hidden for thousands and thousands of years. That ignorance has caused limitless suffering, endless wars, endless crime, endless abuse. Where are they? Oh, they're busy doing other things. It's time we fix this. This is a joke. This is a joke. There are Catholics all over the world that have their hearts in the right place, that diligently follow, you know. That's their process. Their focus at least is on the right thing. Those people. But these guys, they abuse that. It's vanity. It's a violation of taking the Lord's name in vain. How dare you claim lawful authority under the, you know, supreme being. How dare you take the Lord's name in vain and claim sovereignty when no sovereign, no sovereign can do that? It's easy to see that you do not have the lawful authority. A blind man can see it. I suggest you fix this. I don't know if Pope Francis retiring is going to fix this. I say if you start teaching people the law so that we can get rid of these scumbags out there just abusing people with impunity. Where is that? We always had this power, folks. We always had this power. But look, Bergoglio isn't helping you solve the problem. He himself is taking advantage of your ignorance of the law. That's not the behavior of a sovereign. A sovereign must educate those around him such that they are no longer confused. This mechanism, over the ages here, over this time period, has been the primary mechanism of concealing the law and the truth from the rank and file people, from the little people. Wouldn't want to be them right now. They got a lot to answer for. And folks, all it takes is one competent witness. One. Because without a competent witness, you can't see a crime being committed. It's as if the crime didn't exist. Since there is one witness, I think there's more than one now, that's when the power of justice kicks in. What you're seeing now is justice. They talk about February. I call that sloth. They're centuries late on this, folks. Centuries late. They're not doing this because they want to. They're doing it because they don't have a choice. And that's the way things work. All right. Back to the living room. I can only spend time in the basement so long. So, you know, so much for an upbeat message. But you know what? I think it's actually very useful, this. I think people are starting to see that, wait a minute. We need to take a look at who we are. And folks, look, if you do not understand the basic fundamental principles in the law, and look, go to my website, hit me up, right? You know, you guys know my website, right? Right. There's a donation button. You know, if you like this stuff, hey, you know, help me out here. Help me and my, you know, the lovely Beebles who makes this possible. Okay. Thank her. Right, I said that in the video, the last video, the checkpoint video. Thank her. Okay? Me? This is just my job. This is my function. Right? I don't have much of a choice. You know, I don't walk around in, you know, rich robes, you know. I don't have a nice car. I mean, I got a van, you know. Hey, it's the only white van in Austin with the blue door, you know. It's a 1993 Plymouth Voyager, I mean. You know, state of the art back a couple of decades ago, maybe almost three decades, 25 years old. It's a classic, you know. You know, we don't have much, right? And we're not going to have much if we've got people who claim authority and that don't have authority. And we have a population of people on this planet that don't realize that you're dealing with people that have no lawful authority. You know, I cited a primary passage, Romans 13, right? Here's the biggest error of interpretation that is being perpetrated by many of these 501(c) churches. Okay? The original translated text refer to ruler. Okay? The more recent translations have substituted the term ruler for government. Okay? Government and ruler are not the same. Okay? A ruler is a man. A man is accountable to God. A government is a trust. You have public servants. They're accountable. But the government itself is not. It exists only in people's mind. Why? Have you ever walked in and shaken hands with state of Texas? I haven't. How about the federal government of the United States? I'd like to shake his hand. You know, I got some problems with him that I'd like to bring up. It doesn't exist, folks. It's in your head. It's here. It's a fiction. And anybody who says, hey, I am acting on the behalf of the federal government of the United States, really? I need to talk to the federal government of the United States to verify that you indeed have the authority to act on his or her behalf. If you can't, then you're committing a criminal fraud. Now, if you want to be a public servant, okay, you're my servant, right? You're my servant. And as my servant, I expect you to comport yourself strictly according to the law. And you're not doing that. All right? You watch the latest Recon series. There's some enlightening things in that stuff. All right? I don't resist government. I don't. I can't. There isn't true government. It doesn't meet the basic qualification of government. Right? What is the basic qualification? Right? Governments are instituted among men. And they derive their just power by the consent of the governed. Right? That's not what we have. So therefore, it doesn't meet the basic qualifications to call government. You can't resist something that doesn't exist. I don't resist government. In fact, if we actually had lawful government, I'd probably be one of the big proponents. I would deny no man the right to a lawful constitutional government. Absolutely. Absolutely. But that's not what we have here, folks. We have something else. And we need to figure this out. And it would have been nice if the church would have been instrumental in providing the leadership necessary for us to be motivated to learn the law. Instead of us sitting here, you know, absolving ourselves of any kind of responsibility. And when you do that, somebody else is responsible for you. You're basically insane. You're incompetent. Somebody tells you what to do, even against your own will. These guys, they want to march you all in the ocean. Better snap out of it, okay? Better snap out of it. Better wake up, right? There's no sense getting mad about it, right? If you want to be mad, look in the mirror. That's the one you need to be mad at. Evil men, they're always going to be with us. If you have evil men in your environment, you need to look in the mirror and find out why are they given power. Well, you broke the deal. Why is it that you're delivered into the hands of evil men? It's very easy. You're ignorant of the law. And if you don't remedy that, they're going to be more and more powerful, right? For every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. All right? Ask the question, why do I live in a world full of evil men? They're not doing it to you. You're doing it to you. It's an easy fix. It's easy. Simple. You don't requires no violence. You know? You don't have to wear a funny hat. You don't have to hop around on one foot. Right? You don't have to do any of those weird things. All that procedure. You don't have to do any of it. Oh, and no, you don't have to fight for your freedom. That's a lie, folks. Right? Freedom, you are free or you are not free. It's a being. Be free. You don't have to fight for freedom. If you're fighting for freedom, then it's not freedom that you're fighting for. Certainly not your own freedom. Whose freedom are you actually fighting for? There's a lot of people patting themselves on the back because they're fighting for freedom. Yeah. Look around. Do you have any? You want equity, folks. All right? Well, I'm Roge, and we will talk to you later. Bye-bye.